look at HIV infection among males, adult and adolescent, you can see in men almost all HIV, or majority, vast majority, is due to male-to-male sexual contact. And they also refer it as, you know, men having sex with men. So it may or may not be men who identify as gay or bisexual. There are men who will say that they are not gay, but they have sex with other men. So, you know, if you need more information on that, I would suggest, you know, talk to Dr. Hamill about that. This is more her area than mine. But you can see by far in men, it is sexual contact, small percent of injectable drug use. And, you know, there are people who do both. And then, but especially if you look at the non-rural areas, you know, the more rural areas, non-metropolitan areas, increase with heterosexual contact. So these are men who are receiving HIV from women. And these may be, you know, men who may be having sex with prostitutes, or just, you know, people who have had unprotected sex over the years. Let's look at women. So if we look at the HIV transmission rates in women, you can see that almost exclusively it's heterosexual contact, with a very small percent being injectable drug use. So vast differences between men and women. Men, it's almost always male-to-male sexual contact, but in women, it is heterosexual contact. So from a public health perspective, that is something that is really important. Looking at the ages of HIV infection. So what ages are people diagnosed? You can see it does tend to be more so in adolescence and young adulthood. But note there are cases at every age. So there are increasing incidences of HIV in people older than 55 years old, especially in the non-metropolitan areas. So people who are older than 55 feel they don't have to worry about having children anymore. They don't worry about pregnancy. So they may have unprotected sex. So it's not non-existent in older people, but it does tend to be a little bit higher in younger age groups. And then if we're looking at people who actually have full-blown AIDS diagnoses, you can once again see about 50%, especially in large areas, large cities, 50% are African-American, and about 25% both Hispanic and Caucasian, with other ethnic groups making up the other small percentages. But in more rural areas, you can see there are far more people with AIDS that are Caucasian than in metropolitan areas. And note the one in the middle, this would sort of be representative of an area such as Rock Hill. Looking at the regions of the country, note that the non-metropolitan areas are the highest in the South. So I think that's an interesting graph. We do tend to have, you know, much smaller cities in the South versus the Northeast or the West. And so we have much bigger numbers of people in small cities and in rural areas with AIDS. Looking at by race and ethnicity, once again, in large cities, the largest proportion of AIDS diagnoses in adults and adolescents are in the African-American community. It's still higher. They're still the highest in small cities and rural areas as well. And then people with multiple races. So African-Americans are still disproportionately affected by AIDS.